Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the last moment and the last minute tips for SBI Clerk Prelims Exam 2019. So let's begin our video. So coming to the exam mode, the mode of exam is online. So you'll be writing the prelims exam through online, and negative marking will be like 0.25 is the negative marking for each and every wrong answer. So think before you mark, okay, because unnecessarily just don't lose your marks. And coming to the time duration, 1 hour exam, it's a 1 hour exam, complete 1 hour exam. So there will be 100 marks for prelims. So now let's see few more things. Coming to the pattern, there will be English exam, reasoning and numerical ability. And coming to English, there will be 35 questions, and each question will have 1 mark. Like every right answer, you'll be getting 1 mark in bonus. And coming to the numerical ability, 35 questions, 35 marks, and reasoning, 35 questions, 35 marks. So in total, there will be 100 questions for 100 marks. So if you leave the answer unattempted, then you're going to get 0 marks. If you correctly, like if you answer the if you answer correctly, then you're going to get 1 mark. And if you are going to give the wrong answer, 0.25 marks are going to be deducted from your existing marks. So be careful. So now let's see what are the important topics for the exam. First, let's see the tips. Okay, first of all, as you have only few hours left for your exam, what you need to do is first start taking mock test, okay, as many as possible. Take the mock test and you know, just analyze your performance, analyze your you know, time consumption for every mock test, so that during exam tomorrow you can like, you know, you can understand which particular section or which particular question is consuming more time, and you can happily work on that. Okay, so first keep taking mock tests and make sure you you know, consider time. Okay, just on the stopwatch, and within 1 hour just end your mock test, so that even time is important. Okay, because the duration of prelims is just 1 hour. Okay, so mock test. And the second tip is that refer to at least 4 to 5 previous year's papers, because 40 to 50% of previous year's questions, like the similar questions, will be frequently repeating each and every year. So make sure you know, just refer to the previous papers as well. And the third important tip is that time management. Time management is one of the most important factors coming to this particular exam, because if you know the answers of each and every question but you are still running out of the time, then there's no use. You need to manage, you must manage the time. So 100 questions, based upon that you should speed up your solving skills. And if you doubt the answer, if you are not confident about the answer, just leave the answer, don't attempt it, because you're going to lose marks unnecessarily, because this 0.25 negative mark for each and every wrong answer. So if you're not confident, just leave the answer, no problem. Okay, because percentile is important. You know, just don't take the risk of guessing answers. And the fourth important tip is that as you have last few hours left for your exam, what you need to do is please concentrate on important topics rather than starting new topics. Okay, as you have last two or like few hours left, if you start new topics, you will be really confused during exam, and the result is you will be, you know, confused regard, like, you know, during the exam you'll be confused, like the new topics which you learned, you're going to forget that, and you may also forget the topics which you have already learned. So that's why my suggestion is please don't go to the topics which are new now. And and the fifth or sixth, I don't know, the tip is that please make sure you be confident, because I have seen many students who are very nervous during exam will lose marks. Actually, they know the answer, but just because of the tension and just because of their nervousness, they keep losing marks unnecessarily. So just be confident. And the last but not least, all the best. So now let's see what are the important topics and what are the important questions for SBI Clerk Prelims 2019. Let's go. So coming to English, concentrate mostly on spotting the edits. Okay, it's one of the most important topic. Questions will be asked, most of the questions will be asked from this particular topic. So trust me, concentrate coming to English, concentrate on spotting the edits and reading comprehension, sentence rearrangement. These three are the most important topics. Okay. So coming to reasoning, you need to concentrate on direction test, blood relations, coding and decoding, puzzles and syllogism. Okay, so these are the most important topics coming to the reasoning. So coming to the aptitude, concentrate on missing numbers series. Okay, missing number series, they are very important, trust me. So actually coming to this missing numbers, they can give you two different types of series problems. First one is that they'll give you a series in which there will be five numbers. For example, 2, 8, 16, 32, some other 64, okay. So they'll be asking, like they give you five numbers, right? 2, 8, 16, 32, 64. They'll be asking what will, after 64, what number will come? Okay, so this kind of question they may ask. And another question which they may ask is, they'll give you the five numbers in a series and they'll ask you what is the wrong number which is given in the series. So this kind of questions also will be asked. So concentrate mostly on the series and data interpretation. It's very important. Okay, so especially one or two data interpretation sets are gonna come. So please concentrate mostly on the data interpretation and the series. And coming to the seating arrangement in reasoning is very important, trust me. You need to manage your time mostly on data interpretation, seating arrangement, series and reading comprehension. So these four are the particular topics where students will be losing marks. So please concentrate on these four particular topics in regarding of the time management. Okay, so now let's see a few more tips. Yes, I forgot to give you the most important tips. So coming to the aptitude, you will be having formulae, right? You'll be having the formulae, right, which are very important. What you need to do is just make the short notes of each and every important formulae so that you can happily revise them till last moment of your exam time. Okay, so that you know, especially for this particular aptitude, it's really important to keep the formulae in tip of your brain. Okay, because you know, if you just keep thinking all the time, you're going to waste your time. So please maintain the short notes of each and every formulae which is important, which you feel as important, and keep revising all the day, like today and tomorrow, till you go to the exam hall, into the exam hall. So, and another important tip is that coming to the reading comprehension, what you need to do is that first read the questions and then read the paragraph. Okay, read the question and then start searching the related answer of the paragraph. Okay, it really saves a lot of time. This is the best technique and the tip and the trick, whatever you call. So it's really going to help you. So make sure you do that. And coming to series, use the logic. Okay, just don't get confused with the question, because coming to series, if you practice 1,000 problems also, they are going to give you 1,001 question which you didn't practice, because it just needs logic. Okay, the numbers will be like different. It's really tough to solve within 20 seconds. So at least give it 40 to 60 seconds coming to series because it's really important. And if you are confused, please don't try to attempt because you're going to lose your marks. Negative marking is there. So now let's see what are the questions which are very important and which are repeating each and every year. So let's go. So coming to the English, they'll be giving you a paragraph and questions coming to reading comprehension. First read the questions and then start searching the answers regarding that question, related to that question. It saves a lot of time. So coming to the reading comprehension, it's one of the greatest tip. So remember that. And so now let's see what are the questions which are important and similar and which may have higher chances to repeat in tomorrow's exam as well. So let's see. First they'll ask you to find out the meanings. For example, I'm going to give you a word and options. So such kind of questions are going to come in tomorrow's exam. So listen it carefully. The question is compelled. C-O-M-P-E-L-L-E-D, compelled, okay? So, compelled, what is the meaning of compelled, okay? Options are discouraged, delayed, suspended, forced. I'm repeating the question. What is the meaning of compelled? C-O-M-P-E-L-L-E-D. Options are discouraged, delayed, forced, and suspended. The correct answer is, the meaning of compelled is forced. If you are compelled to do something, it means that someone are forcing you to do something, okay? So like this, you need to put the word in a paragraph, like the put the word in a paragraph and should think logically so that you may get the answer easily, okay? So now let's see opposites. What is the opposite antonym of folly? F-O-L-L-Y, folly. Options are sharpness, stupidity, madness, advancedness. Okay, sharpness, stupidity, madness, advancedness. The correct answer is folly is the opposite of advancedness. Okay, like this, antonyms are like, you know, damn important. So now let's see a few more questions. Concentrate on, like, fill in the blanks also. They are also very important. So make sure you concentrate. Coming to the questions, they're going to give you a question and they'll ask you what answer will come in the place of question mark. Let's see the question. 7/5 of 58 plus 3/8 of 139.2 is equal to how much? I'm repeating the question. 7/5 of 58 plus 3/8 of 139.2 is how much? Options are 133.4, 137.2, 131.6. Okay, it's very easy. First you have to find the 7/5 part of 58 and you have to find the 3/8 part of 139.2. Add both the answers and then you're going to get the answer as 133.4. okay, like this you need to solve keeping the time in mind. Okay, and a few more important questions are coming to the data interpretation. It is important, concentrate mostly on the data interpretation. And the questions from ratios are going to come in tomorrow's exam. And interest problems, annual interest, compound interest, simple interest and all. So I'm not discussing each and every question. The questions which are having so much importance, yes, I'm going to discuss that only. So now let's see one of the series question. They give you the 5 numbers and are asking you to find the number which is in the 6th position. Okay, let's see. 2, 15, 41, 80, 132. What is the next number? Okay, 2, 15, 15, 41, 80, 132. After 132, what number is going to come is the question, okay? Options are 197, 150, 160, 180. The correct answer is you're going to get 197 after 132, okay? Like that, you need to solve each and every question with a logic. So series is having greatest importance, so please concentrate on that. It's really gonna increase your marks, so please concentrate. And syllogism, very very important. So and few more questions are, yes, I forgot to tell you the important tip. So coming to the seating arrangement, first try to understand the question, okay? In few questions, the question will be asked like, all the people are sitting facing towards center, okay? In next question, like second type of question will be asked like, all the students or all the people are sitting facing opposite to the direction of center, okay? And it may be the circular seating arrangement or linear seating arrangement and all. So first you need to understand the question well. So concentrate on the question, imagine the picture in your mind, and then start solving the question, okay? So it's very important. And yes, remaining rest of questions, topics which we already discussed. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos. And also don't forget to like and share this video. And the important thing is, tomorrow I'm going to review the paper of SBI Clerk Prelims 2019. So that's why don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon, so that whenever I make a video, it will be notified in your mobile. So that's it for today. All the very best for your exam. So just don't stress yourself. Be confident. You're going to do well. Just stay positive. Thanks. Thanks for watching, and all the very best for your exam. Like and share this video. Subscribe and hit the bell icon. Thanks. Thanks for watching.